What is halal? Is it permissible? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. There is no concept of a halal in Islam, into the Sharia. Halal is something where if a woman gets a divorce from her husband, and three divorces are being completed, and now she becomes a haram for the husband, then she has to marry someone else. And then if that in that life with that husband the life is not going on, and then this being life is being disturbed, and that second husband would divorce her, and she is allowed to go back to the husband, to the previous husband where she was already being divorced, or she can marry somebody else, she can do whatever she can do. So back in the South Asian countries, this has been too much spread, and this is really an opening a door to the zina. This is an opening door to an adultery, because the concept of a halal doesn't even exist. It's not allowed, because if you first of all, why things started from, what is the root cause of that? The root cause of that is the scholars of some other sect of Islam. They pronounce the husband and wife that your relation has become a haram because you have pronounced the three talaq into the one sitting. So now you have to do the halala. Now the husband is crying, the kids are crying, and the mother is crying. They are being separated. They are being, their family being blown up, and now they're finding way how to hook up back together. So rather, on the group that does not follow into the Hanafi madhab, or does not follow any madhab, basically they just follow the Quran and they follow the teaching of the Prophet ﷺ, and what is the better for life to do that, how to make the things easier. So rather than opening a door to the zina, rather than opening a door to an adultery and more complications, when it comes to when the people come to the people who are the salaf, who are the ahl hadith people, they are the one who your talaq is not happened, because if you pronounce the three talaq into the one time, that consider as the one, and you have an option to delay on this one, and then you can take her back during the time, or you can pronounce a second time if the life is not going on, you can pronounce so the second time, or you can during the either time you can take her back. Even you pronounce like a three time or the one time, that happened as a one, so that gives a time to take her back. Now what happens, like this husband wife goes to their own imams, their scholars, their leaders, and they pronounce them your life has been screwed up and your family is broken, you are not halal to each other. Now look and learn, try to understand this logic. This husband and wife, they have their own life. When they get a dispute, they go to the third person to get an opinion. Please, like decide for our life. Why the third person has to decide for your life? Allah has sent us the Quran, and also the life of the Prophet ﷺ, how to think, how to handle the matters. But these particular scholars from other sect, they are following their own madhab, they are following their own teaching, they are making their own interpretations. Do you know how many messages that I have been receiving, like in not in hundreds, but I would say in thousands? Everyone has the same problem when they go to the local imam, local scholar, or the Hanafi scholar, or any scholar. They have pronounced them husband and wife no longer, and their life is broken, and now they have to find the way of a halala. And what happens, that those scholars who involved in this matter, they set up the woman to go marry him, and they're going to do that. And the halala is something where if the woman has a niyyah, if the man has a niyyah that she's going to get married to another person, and with the niyyah that she's going to get a divorce back again, and she's going to come back again, this is all zina. This is adultery. This is fahish. This is not Islam. The scholars have their made up on own logics to do that. Because when you say that, when you have a niyyah of something to do that, that's a haram. Because if you want to get married to somebody else, you have to have a natural niyyah to get along with your life. Your divorce is finished with the husband, with the three, the period. Though life is finished, now naturally you have to make an intention to go marry somebody else. Now naturally, if you don't get get along with that husband, then that woman has an option to go back to the previous husband, or she can marry to somebody else. But making a knee of that, you're going to be doing this and you have planned up everything with your life, and this is totally not permissible. This is haram, and this is called an adultery, and this is called and that imam, that scholars, that maulana, that makes a woman like a prostitute and make her like a zania and then make her adulterer, selling her to another man, then what's the difference between this situation and the muta? That's what they do, having a contract. Life is not a contract. The marriage is not a contract that you make a niya to do this. That becomes haram, because when you make a niya, like, who are these people are fooling? Are they fooling Allah? Astaghfirullah. Are they fooling? Who are they fooling? Anything you have to do, you have to have a pure 100% niya to do that. And how did the whole problem start from? It started from when the Muslim brother and the Muslim sister does not know the process of a divorce. Even a man is a very angry, and the brother is a very extremely angry, and he shooted three words of divorce, like, I divorce you, I divorce you, I divorce you, I give you talaq, you just get out of my life. That divorce is not being ended. That relationship is not ended because he has either time. Because what happens, naturally, more than 95% cases are being seen where the husband and wife want to go back together. When the husband, his temper is over, he become calm down, he's being relaxed, and the next day the wife is comfortable. Now they have a problem. They come into an understanding that my husband has shooted three bullets to me and killed me. They go to the scholar. The scholar naturally tell them, okay, your divorce has been completed, and now she has to do halala. There's no concept of a halala, because halala is something opening a door to the zina. It's opening a door to an adultery. The marriage is not over at all. So do not even think about it that the marriage is over. The sect scholars and the imams, the maulanas, whoever issued the divorce, they are following their own scholars. They are following their own system of an education that they were putting onto your head. They are breaking your family. Because naturally, the person, the brother who's a bit angry, naturally, next day his anger is gone. Next day the sister anger is gone. Now they're comfortable. They want to live together, but they go to the imam. The imam tells them, okay, your life is broke, and the life is being screwed up, your family is being screwed up, and now I am ready to marry you. Now this is something, a new logic that the imam, maulana, or the scholar, or mufti, or whatever, they come to a conclusion, they come to our the solution that, okay, I can marry you and you can spend some time with me, and then I'm going to divorce you. But doing all this, this maulana is not a maulana, he's a shaitan. This whoever is being advising this thing is not a human being. It's a shaitan in a human form who is being making her intention, who is making her to make this niya to marry me and do this and do that. If not me, then I would have someone who is going to marry, and then he's going to divorce, and then you're going to go back to your previous husband. Why you have to all do all these things? First of all, let's understand that the talaq does not happen like shoot it at one time and just get out of my life, and that life is over. Now she has to marry another man, you have to go back. Because the way of the proper way of the divorce is, even the man shoot her one time or the three time at the one sitting, that is not happened. And even he shoot it at one time or the three time, still we have to know if that was being affected or not, because he might be because she might be in her period, she might be lost her control, she might be not in her conscience, and the man is not in his conscience. So we have to know many things before offering our opinion, because first we have to go more into the background, investigate, and ask a lot of questions before issuing our opinion.